Hello everyone, Donnell HD here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Commodore Amiga emulator FSUAE on Launchbox. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder I have my Launchbox folder, my emulators folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left a link in the description below for everything that you're going to need to get set up right away. All you have to do is click here on download. I also left a link to the Open Retro Game Database website where you're going to need to make an account. Up here at the top right hand corner is where you log in and click register here to create an account, and just put your email here. Alright, I've downloaded the Amiga Necessities file and I placed it here on my desktop. What I'm going to do is extract the contents of it into the emulators folder. Now we're going to run the emulator for the first time. So we're going to go here in the emulators folder, FS-UAE, FS-UAE Launcher, Windows, x86-64 folder, and click on the FS-UAE Launcher here. Okay, when the emulator opens up, it's going to look something like this. I do have my Xbox controller already plugged in, and I see here it's detecting it as an X input controller. It's already pre-configured, so you don't have to worry about configuring it. At the bottom here, click to import Kickstart ROMs. In the Import Kickstarts and ROMs section, click Browse here, and go to the location where you extracted your emulator to. In my case, mine is on the emulators, FSUAE, and the Kickstart folder. Once you have that folder, click Select Folder here, and then click the Import button. Once it's done, it will let you know that 12 ROM files were imported. Click the X button here, and here. Our next step is to go to the check icons at the top left corner here. We're going to go here to log in and register. And when you created your Open Retro account, put your email and password here. And it will begin to update the database. This process can take anywhere between 2 and 3 minutes. Alright, after you updated the database, you're going to see a screen like this right here with a whole bunch of games on the left hand panel, but none of them actually work. This download game section here does not work either, so you're going to have to find your ROMs by other means. Now we're going to go back to the blue check mark at the top left corner here. I'm going to go to Settings, Video, and right here where it says Start FS-UAE in Full Screen Mode, I'm going to turn this on. Now I'm going to go to File, Database. Alright, so this is very important. You must have WHD load ROMs. So wherever you get your ROM set from, make sure you get a WHD load ROM set. So now I'm going to click this plus sign here. And you're going to direct it to where your ROMs are located. My ROMs, once again, are located on the desktop, arcade, ROMs folder. And I created a folder in here called Amiga ROMs here. So I'm going to click select folder. And then I'm going to click on this X here to close. Now we're going to go to the blue check mark at the top left corner here one more time, and we're going to click on Update, File, Database. Click the Scan button here, and allow it to scan for your games. Once it's done, click Close. And now when I roll down this bar here, I go to the location where some of my games are. I can see that these white icons here indicate that I've imported these games correctly. So here's RoboCop, and here's The Spy Who Loved Me. Now we're going to close this emulator up, and we're going to set it up in Launchbox. Alright, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're going to go to the three lines at the top left corner here. Going to click Tools, Manage, Emulators. Going to click Add. The name of our emulator is FS-UAE. Now I'm going to set the path. My location is on my desktop, Arcade, Emulators, FS-UAE, FS-UAE Launcher, Windows, x86-64, and FS-UAE Launcher here. I'm going to go to Associated Platforms, and the name of the platform you should put here is Commodore Amiga. And I'm going to click this check mark here to set it as my default emulator. Now I'm going to go here to the running script area, and I left the script in the description below that if you require it, it allows you to escape out of the emulator easily by pressing the escape key. I'm just going to paste that here, and then I'm going to click OK, and then close. Now it's time to import our games. I'm using the drag and drop method here again, so I'm going to go here to my ROMs folder, and I'm going to simply drag this folder into Launchbox like so. What type of game files are you importing? We're going to say ROM files, What platform are you importing games for? Make sure it says Commodore Amiga. Next, choose an emulator. Make sure it says FS-UAE here. Next, use the files in our current location. Next, 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 next. Make sure your games are spelled correctly, and then click Finish. Alright, now that I've imported everything, it's time to test out our games.
When you load your games, usually takes about 3 to 5 seconds to load up, so just be patient.
And it loads up.
Check this out.
And if at any time you'd like to reset the game, simply push Start on your controller, and then go to Reset Amiga. Soft reset. And it resets the game. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I've created many tutorials for other platforms as well. Just follow the thumbnails on the screen. As always, I'm DonLHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.